On behalf of the family, I want to thank everyone for being here to celebrate the Lynn, the life of Lynn, or Lynn Marie, as I've heard her called most of my life. As I was asked to speak here today, let me be honest with you, I'm not much of a speaker. And I'm not real good with words, but thank God I got a wife that knows pretty good and helped write most of this. So, we were talking on the way down here about Lynn. It's a pretty good wife from North Georgia, but time of my life with Lynn and Misty was spent mostly at my grandmother's JoJo's and the time we went and spent in Kansas with them. Then later as adults with our own children. Most of us know Lynn is a great artist and she loved coloring. Stephanie said she remembers one night at JoJo's. Lynn had some kind of rough night and asked her to color with her. Stephanie says at times she didn't think much of it, but she knows now that was Lynn's attempt to keeping it together. That was her therapy. She was trying to keep it between the lines, but Lynn wasn't meant to keep it between the lines. Did you ever ride with her? So, seriously, Lynn was a life, live life and color and live a little sparkle with everyone, everywhere she went kind of person. She faced so many battles in her life, but did not stop her from loving. I say we take the example set by Lynn and apply it to our own lives. We all face battles, we all deal with stuff, but we all have power to love. As in Mark 12:31 says, say, love your neighbor as yourself. Now, I'm not going to stand up here in lines that Lynn never fell victim to this world and its evils in his life, but she never failed to love others. Her fault was forgetting to love herself, too. She wanted to make others happy, but can't love correctly when you're running on fumes. I don't know your walk with God, if maybe the situation may you want to check on that. I know it has me in mind, but I do know that in this world with so much bad, Lynn was some of good, and was proud to call her my cousin. Now, I do truly believe Lynn is now at peace, and I know that she would not want us to be sad. She wants us to find our own peace, and I only know one way to do that. Philippians 4:7 says, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Jesus Christ. Let's pray. Lord, we come to you first, as always, with gratitude. We thank you for the 35 years you blessed this earth with Lynn. We thank for the blessings, Brandon and Christopher, in who a little bit of Lynn's life lives on. We'll ask you to be with Brandon and Christopher, as well as Tim and Patricia and Misty, as they all try to figure out how to move forward, provide them with the peace that passes all understanding, and surround them with your unfailing love. Lord, in our times of weakness, please use this to remember, through your Son, Jesus, we can find peace. In his name we pray. Amen.
Seem to heal. This pain is just too real. it chased away all the sanity.